Yo, what's up, everybody? It's your girl MC Etta Does It Better, and this is another episode of Gumbo Radio. And yes, I took a week off. Well, not a week, but I guess I took a week off. Felt good. So today on the menu, we're going to talk about the pleasure of privacy. Yes, the pleasure of it. And I love privacy, you know. People think just because you have social media that you have to let everybody into your world every time. No, you don't. People don't have to know what you're doing. I don't know how people got caught up into that, letting everybody know what you're doing, everything all the time. No. Anybody who follows me know that I don't post my husband. It's only a handful of people. Probably I can even count on one hand of people who know what my husband looks like. And it's not just because I don't want people to know what he looks like. I mean, I just feel like what comes with all the posting of, I don't know. I just enjoy people not knowing what he looks like. And over there, you know, because my husband is from Jamaica, and when he's over there, because he runs track, everybody knows him. Every time we go out, we're stopped. Everybody is just, and you know, over here, because don't nobody know what he looks like, I don't have to worry about that. Especially now that we have masks on, people won't really know who he is. So, and then, you know, I just never had any really just, you know, people post people and the relationship don't ever just last long, and then now you got this person on your wall, and then you got another person, and it's just like, you could just eliminate all of that by just not showing no face, you know?
Gotta play it safe, huh? No face, no case.
Exactly. So, and it ain't just about posting all of your business on social media. It's not just your love life and your kids and your personal life. You got to think about your business too, because people pray against you. People don't ever want to see you doing better than them. So you just got to limit yourself to what you expose the world to. Even when I see a lot of people who are working out, you know, getting their self together, getting their self in shape, you know, and then when you post, and you feel like you got to keep these people up with your journey, and then you don't want to work out because you feel like, well, I don't feel like videotaping it, I don't feel like posting it. Well, shit, don't. You know, just work out for you. You know, continue to, you know, get record yourself for you. You don't have to record it to prove people a point. And not just for that, I have to sometimes be telling myself that too. Like, well, I'm going to work out, but I don't feel like working out because I don't feel like recording it. Like, what you recording it for? Hell, you know what you look like working out? Especially if you work out in the mirror. I just don't be understanding. But we're going to take a break, and we'll continue when we come back.
I need your body in ways that you don't understand, but I'm losing my patience, 'cause we've been going over and over again. Girl, I just want to take you home and get right into it. No one gotta kiss it, baby, give it to me, lick it inside now. You know that I just wanna make love, want you to scream and shout. And baby, when I'm deep in it now, I'ma slow it down, 'cause ain't no speed limit when we're moving at the speed of sound. We gon' turn all the way up when the lights down. Why your pussy so damn good, Miss Lady? Go on, put that booty up.
Back, ladies and gentlemen. You know, can't never go wrong with Chris Brown. But yes, back to the privacy. Okay, so you know, we use social media and all these other platforms, and we post our lives and, you know, let people in to our sacred lives. But I just want to let y'all know that you don't, well, I'm pretty sure y'all know you don't have to put people in everything. Like, you know, I see people post their business, their dramas, their beefs, and all that other stuff. and, you know, how they get their money and their side hustles. I'm like, where is the privacy? Like, why are y'all letting people know so much? You know what I'm saying? But I just feel like I like to, like, I don't even really like posting my children, because I feel like that alone itself is just too much. But I don't know. And, you know, I've never been a fan of just posting all of my business and dirt on social media. You know, I think people who can do that are brave. It's kind of like they, you know, they can't keep a secret. If you're telling your own business, you can tell somebody else's. So I don't know, that they brave for that number. And, you know, the good thing about privacy and limiting people on what you allow them to see in your life, well, when they finally get to meet you and they're shocked about what you have going on in your life. You know, I get that a lot. Like, I didn't know you had this going on, and I didn't know you had that going on. Because, yeah, you know, some of the stuff, like I said, you don't post it because people can pray against you. And don't nobody want to see nobody doing better than them. But you have to limit yourself on what you expose people to. And another reason I just be so, you know, hesitant to post and enjoy the privacy, because these people is watching us, and they be doing all that, post your spouse, post your relatives, post your dog, post your, you know, all this other stuff that they have y'all post. And it's just like, it's just, you can't tell me that they ain't tracking and watching. You know what I'm saying? Trying to keep a track who you had on those taxes, who you claimed on that stimulus ain't matching up with these people you keep posting on your page. I don't know. I'm just talking. But let's just take a break and we'll be right back. Let me know that I've done wrong when I've known this all along. I go around a time or two just to waste my time with you. Tell me all that you're throwing away. Find out games you don't want to play. You are the only one that needs to know. I'll keep you my dirty little secret. Don't tell anyone or you'll be just another regret. My dirty little secret. Who has to know when we live such fragile lives? It's the best way we survive. So earlier, you know, I was telling y'all that, you know, I don't post my husband, but it's always been like that. Even when we were dating, I never post him, because like, you don't know, you don't want to jinx anything. And I don't know, that's just my mentality. I feel like you put that stuff out there, people pray against you, and, you know, it just don't work out. But I'm not going to say that be the reason, but, you know, you never know. So I'm just saying, just limit, you know, what you post, and it makes it better on the relationship. You know, a lot of these men or women, you know, really don't want their business all out on social media, you know. And I even asked my husband, you know, how does he feel that, you know, I don't post him? And he was like, he don't care, because, you know, he don't have social media, so it's not like he's missing anything or anybody would be missing him. So, because, you know, like I said, people ask me all the time, why don't you post your husband? What's the secret? Why so private? I mean, I just enjoy it, you know what I'm saying? I enjoy it of not posting him. And, you know, I'm not telling people what to do with their social media. I'm just simply saying that it's a lot easier if you keep things limited, you know. You know, people kind of get confused when, you know, oh, it's my page, I get to post what I want. Yes, that is correct, you know. But like I said, you have to, like, limit the things that you should want to post just to make light of yourself. And I think if you don't post your drama and your tea, you won't get so much anxiety, or you won't have so much stress, you won't have so many negative thoughts, many bad feelings. Because let me tell you, social media is not the place to be venting, and putting all your stress and your business all out there, because, you know, most of the times people don't care what you're going through. Yeah, they want to see it. Yeah, they want to be in your business, but they don't care. This is just more of dirt or more information that they got on you, especially if they don't like you. They go like, they got all types of stuff going on. So, like I say, just be careful. Privacy is key. You should want to post, like, just continue to post, you know, your thriving business, entrepreneurship, positive things that you have going on in your life, you know, and, you know, how you can help the world. And yes, it is easier on your life when you're not posting so much of your life on social media. You know, I find it works in my work life, in my marriage, in my home. All of that is perfect because, well, I'm not going to say it's perfect, but I don't have conversations of, oh, you're exposing too much on social media. So just privacy is key. It'll eliminate a whole bunch of negative thoughts, feelings, people being in your business if you keep it limited. I don't know why people post bad things on social media anyway. I mean, I guess because they want you to see, well, it ain't all peaches and cream. That ain't nobody's business if it ain't all peaches and cream. Keep it peaches. Keep it creamy. You know, keep it limited. Don't open that door to have people being able to gossip badly about your life because of the things you post. And I'm going to leave that right there. And we will be right back.
You are listening to MC Etta Does It Better on Gumbo Radio.
Drop a roll at the partition, please. I don't need you seeing your say on her knees. Took 45 minutes to get all dressed up. We ain't even gonna make it to this club. Now my mascara running red lipstick smudge. Oh, he's so horny, yeah, he want too far. He popped on my buttons and he ripped my blouse. He Monica Lewinsky'd all on my gown. Water daddy, daddy didn't bring the towel. Poor baby, baby, be better, slow it down. Took 45 minutes to get all dressed up. And we ain't even gonna make it to this club.
Take all of me. I just wanna be the girl you like. Girl you like. The kind of girl you like. Girl you like. Take all of me. I just wanna be the girl you like. Girl you like. The kind of girl you like is right here with me. Right here with me. Right here with me.
Travel roll at the park.
Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. Now, okay, before I get out of here, there's just one last thing, just one little tip that I would just like to leave. You know, when it comes to this privacy thing, you have to try to treat it like, I don't want people, or do I want people knowing this, or how is people going to use this, or do I even care? You know, some people really don't care about what they let the world see, so I don't know, but you have to treat it like it's sacred. Keep it sacred. Limit it, the things that we post on our social media. Because let me tell you, there'll be some days where I'll be wanting to let people have it. Rip them a new one. But I'm like, I'm not gonna give them no shine, no light on my social media. And then I don't want to speak negative and put negativity out on my social media for the world to see and to use against me and to, you know, to know my business and what's going on in my life and with my family and stuff like that. So it'd be hard, I'm not gonna lie, because, you know, people be going in putting their business out on social media. But you gotta limit it. You have to keep that stuff to yourself. Keep it in the closet. And so that is going to be my end. Well, I'm going to keep this topic short. Privacy is key. You know, it'll prevent a lot of things if you just limit yourself on what you share. And that's all, folks. So I'm going to get on out of here. And we're going to let Michael Jackson tell us how to keep it in the closet. I'm MC Etta Does It Better, and this is Gumbo Radio.
You're just a lover.